And now your weather with Chief Meteorologist Cameron Moreland.
Away from Lake Michigan, temperatures were back up into the 90s once again today, including a reading of 96 degrees in Wapaka. Today was the fifth straight day with highs in the 90s, making this the longest June streak of 90s since 1988. And that ended up being a hot summer with lots and lots of 90s continuing through July and August. We'll have to wait and see what happens this year. All right, over the next 7 days, we have the chance for some more 90s. Tomorrow looks like upper 80s to lower 90s, lower 90s on Thursday, probably the lower half of the 90s on Friday. And then some cooler weather is going to start to work back in here for the weekend and especially early next week. Right now, near Lake Michigan, temperatures are very warm in the mid to upper 80s. Further inland, we're looking at a lot of 90s, including a reading of 92 degrees in Wautoma and 95 degrees in Mountain. In Appleton, it is mostly sunny and 88. We have southeast winds coming in off of Lake Winnebago, cooling it down slightly. In Green Bay, it is 91 degrees and dew points are currently in the upper 60s to around 70. And that means it is sticky outside, and that means it was also hot and humid today, the combination of the heat and the humidity. And when you combine the two, you get the heat index. That's what it actually feels like outside right now. It feels like 94 degrees in Green Bay. It feels like 94 in Oconto. Mountain right now is coming in with a heat index of 105. Now, the heat and humidity helping to fire up some scattered showers and thunderstorms across the viewing area earlier today as a lake breeze moved off towards the west. But now our attention is turning to a frontal boundary dropping in from the north, and that is kicking off some showers and thunderstorms here from north of Iron Mountain back towards Rhinelander. And we do have a couple of severe thunderstorm warnings here across the UP. Now, as we head through the evening, widespread severe weather or organized severe weather is not expected across the state. But of course, anytime you have a thunderstorm, there's always that threat that it could become strong to severe. You can see the bulk of the thunderstorm activity will remain well to the north and west of Green Bay as we head through the evening, most of it sliding back towards the south and west as this frontal boundary, a quasi-stationary front, which means it's wobbling north and wobbling south just a bit. Tonight, it's going to actually wobble south and then drop to our south tomorrow, which means we're going to have a northeast wind coming in off the bay and lake. High temperatures today south of that front, mainly in the 90s. But tomorrow, with winds turning more to the north and east, we will see a bit of a cool down. Highs more than likely in the 80s right near the bay and lake. And that means that the stretch of 90s could come to an end here in the Fox Valley. We have to wait and see. So tonight, a few storms are possible, especially across the far north. Tomorrow, still very warm to hot and humid, upper 80s to lower 90s away from the lake and bay. My 3-degree guarantee for tomorrow is 89. If I can hit that high within 3 degrees, we will donate $100 to the Krivitz Area Food Pantry. And we did that today. I forecast a high of 90, and the actual high temperature was 92 degrees. Mainly lower 90s then for Thursday and Friday. Sunshine, maybe an isolated storm, and then cooling down as we head through the weekend into early next week. John?
Those 70s might feel nice after this heat wave, Cameron.